Senator Nova Peris is being accused of using taxpayers' money to have an affair with Olympic medalist Ato Bolden. A Northern Territory News investigation claims Ms. Peris sought funds from Athletics Australia and other sources to pay for Bolden's trip to Australia from LA to take part in the Jumpstart to London program in 2010. The Northern Territory News obtained and published explicit emails between Peris and Bolden detailing their affair. Peris has denied any wrongdoing and Bolden has threatened legal action over the allegations. Pete, what do you reckon? Is it okay to be going through the private emails of politicians?
I wouldn't think so, but I don't want people going through my emails either. I'm always curious as to why people commit things to things that are easily got at. I mean, surely you open a random email account that's anonymous and use that. I'm intrigued as to what exactly freaky was. I don't know what was freaky about it. Look, the idea of politicians using the public purse for their own escapades, we're constantly seeing it and we will continue to see it. I'm of a belief that unless it is directly affecting us to a large degree or the job they're doing, knock yourself out. Do whatever you want, so long as if you can get the buses to run on time and the trains to run on time. I don't care what you do in your private life.
I mean, exactly. And I think, though, the thing is, to me, no, they're... email should not have been hacked into at all. It is not remotely...
We don't know they were hacked.
Well, how does someone get someone's private email?
Well, isn't the app... But do politicians politicians have private emails?
If this is the thing, yeah.
If you're using your taxpayer-funded office and the taxpayers-funded computer... Yeah. And you've been elected by the taxpayers. Do you have a private
life? Well, this was when she was an official for... Yeah. Before she was a politician, when she was an official, but I think it was a taxpayer-funded organisation. Mm. So there's those questions. Mm. I actually think it's very fascinating. I think it's one of these massive grey areas that is going to be one of those things that may actually define a whole generation. Mm. Email has really only been the dominant form of communication for people. Really, when you think about it, it seems like forever, but really just the last 10 or 15 years or so. And we've seen there's a huge amount of similarity here with what's happened with... Professor Barry Spurr, the Sydney professor who was suspended for making all those racist comments in his
emails. I was thinking about that too, because I was trying to weigh up, because I was so angry about that particular instance, but here I'm sort of on Nova Peris's side, and I was trying to work out why is that, and it made me think, well, I don't think there's any public interest in knowing that she and this other athlete were engaged in an affair. That doesn't interest
the public.
Don't know that it was public money, because... Ato Bolton's come out subsequently and said he's going to take legal action and he says that there are gross fabrications in the article, so we don't know that public money was used.
Well, the email does suggest that that's the issue and that's what they're saying.
But then with Professor Spurr, I think... I think it is in the public interest that we saw the information in those emails, because he was involved in very publicly... responsible for public education policy and possibly changing how kids are educated. Sure. And I think we need to know what his views are.
I think they're both... I know we need to wrap, but you can't just say that you approve of one thing being leaked because you agree with the contents of that, and one thing being not being leaked because you don't agree with the contents of that.
I think the moral out of all this is that you do not send emails to people using the four-letter F word saying you'd like to do it.
But freaky is six letters.
Yes, well, I didn't put the ing on.